Hi, it's Robert and Brad with a Clarity Digital Clip of the Week, and we're at the Texas A&M campus at the May School of Business with Dr. Venky Shankar to talk about how do you respond to a crisis and think about it before it ever happens in the digital age.
Yeah, I think one of the things we've seen over the last, you know, probably a couple of months is there's been a lot of stuff going on out there with some crises, Southwest Airlines, the Starbucks. You mentioned a new one from 2016 that has resurfaced with American Airlines. And you kind of have a process of the 6, 7 A's that you like to go through and teach. And we wanted to be sure we give this to our audience. So tell us a little bit about your 6 A's in a crisis management situation.
And this is research-based.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And I've been doing a lot of research in crisis management, particularly product harm crisis, product recalls, and trying to see what would be the best strategy. And I have the 6 to 7 A's of crisis management. And before I go into that, let's take the two examples that you briefly mentioned about. You know, you had the Starbucks situation and the American Airlines. 2 years ago, a passenger passed away, unfortunately, because she could not get access to a doctor, where the doctor on board asked it to be diverted, and American Airlines decided not to divert. And the response to American Airlines was that we are looking into the complaint. And whereas the response of Starbucks CEO, as soon as the handcuffing of the African-American two people happened, immediately apologized, wanted to have a face-to-face meeting with these two people, and also institute a
racial... They took control, right?
Yeah, they took control, racial profile, racial... sensitivity training that they had instituted, closing down all the locations. All of them is done very swiftly.
Yeah, he treated them like humans.
Yes.
That valued customers.
Yes. Exactly. Yeah. And also very swiftly, all of these. And this is where the 6 A's come in. The first A is to anticipate. Don't wait for the crisis to really happen for you to act on it.
Right.
So good firms nowadays in the digital age, that's the difference between pre-digital age and digital and post-digital age. Social media age of social media, where anything that happens, any negative event, gets amplified.
Oh, yeah.
And it gets stored and accumulated.
In seconds.
And then it gets viral. And so you don't have the luxury of hoping that in the past people say a crisis happens, wait for some time till you ascertain the facts, till it blows over, it's replaced by another crisis, right, in the news. But now you don't have the luxury of, so that's why anticipating. What does anticipating mean? Having like a social media war room or command center where you monitor each and everything that is said about your brand, about shared about it, and pictures, videos that are being shared about you. And Dell is a good example. They have a command center that in which they 24/7 they monitor that.
That's minute
a good,
by minute.
Minute by minute. Yeah.
Well, I think one of the things we talked about previously is that what better group to anticipate something going wrong than the people that are in your company?
Exactly.
To say, all right, here's a crisis.
How would you respond?
How would we respond?
That's what I would suggest based on the research, is that being proactive and anticipatory means that not only anticipating before a crisis hits, but also preparing what to do when the crisis hits by looking at others or teachable moments, right? If you were Dell and you looked at the Southwest Airlines crisis, look at what would you have done if you had experienced that.
Yeah.
That's the first A. And then second A is acknowledge. Acknowledge something has happened. It took about 4 days for the Facebook CEO to even come out of the hiding and say there's a problem that happened. That's acknowledgement. And before that, it was too late. As you know, Facebook lost about 37 million market cap in the 4 days and went up to 75 billion later on. But that's the second A. And the third A is basically apologize. Now, a lot of people think, wait a minute. My company may not be at fault. Why should we apologize, right?
Yeah.
But apology here really is the equivalent of empathizing with the affected party. It doesn't necessarily mean you're acknowledging liability or you're just saying you're at fault. Apologies could be heartfelt, sincere, and it should resonate with the affected party.
But what happened when the lawyers write the apology and it's corporate speak?
It is, unfortunate. It's and a lot of firms are boxed in by that. You know, they issued very canned responses, like we regret, and
that's not audience speaking.
And is that more harm?
That is more harmful because let me talk a little bit about my research. We had two papers published in the last 2 years in top journals, and what we looked at was the impact of product recalls, and especially in the automobile industry. What does it do to the brand equity, or to the consumer trust in the brand, and also the shareholder value of the brand? And how, what does it depend on? And does it depend on not just the severity of the problem, the immediacy of action? What did they voluntarily come out with the admission? Yeah. Or did they delay it on the corrective actions that they took? All of this we factored into account. What we found was in the short term, yes, you can arrest the decline by just stalling it, but in the long term, it hurts you more. And right. These are the kind of be truthful, do think like a, when you're in a crisis mode, think like the customer. Do not think like a firm. That means you, if you're a CEO, you've got to ask yourself, what if I'm the affected customer or the family? Then how would I respond, right? What would I want the firm to do for me?
And I think you said it best in very business technical terms, just do what's right.
Right, exactly.
Just exactly. Do what's right.
As simple as it sounds, people yeah. don't understand. And that's yeah. why we did the research to show the long-term effects. This only shows up in the long term, and lots of times firms do not wait that long to see the effects. And corresponding to that is admit. If you have anything to do with that, admit. Even if it don't have to be perfectly at fault, even if you have partially at fault. So take the example of United CEO when the passenger, Dr. Dai, was dragged off the plane. First reaction was to say the employees did the right thing, right? Without really thinking yep. through the issue. Not only does it not show the empathy, but also it shows a lack of willingness to admit. Obviously, even if there was something wrong with the passenger, nobody should be dragged. At least that was a
right.
that you don't need to do an investigation. You should have admitted, right?
Yeah, we don't need 3 days to analyze that. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I think that's the fifth A is amend, make amends, fix the problem genuinely. Now don't just show superficially that you're changing something. Show how you've fixed it. So if it's a car recall, show how nicely it's done, how clearly it's done, how they are compensated, what changes you made to the process. People want assurance. It's all about brand trust.
Absolutely.
Can I trust this brand again, whether it's Southwest, American, Facebook, Equifax, all of these are brands that get diluted. And can I trust this brand? The only way you can do that is to show that you've fixed the process.
Yes.
That leads to these problems.
It shouldn't happen in the future.
Right.
And are we in a low-trust environment these days online?
Very, very. Unfortunately, in this digital social media world, people's trust of brands is pretty low.
It's low.
Because they're not listening to the brand messages. They are forming their own messages. And they may actually take over the brand message if the firms do not anticipate that and do the correct thing.
And one of the things we say is that if you don't tell your own story in an authentic, empathetic manner, someone else is going to tell it in a whole different
way.
And you won't like it.
And you may not have control over it beyond a point in time. And that's where
it can happen that quick.
Right.
That's the other thing that a lot of clients don't understand is it can happen in minutes.
Right. You know? And that's where the sixth A comes in, which is really you want your affected customers to become an ambassador for the brand. Mm-hmm. So you want advocacy. So the sixth A is advocate. So in other words, get the affected people to come out and say, wow, this company really reacted correctly, quickly, fixed the problem. I want to trust this brand for the long term.
I mean, I saw that in social media with the Southwest issue and accident, that the amount of people that came onto their Facebook pages and in their social media supporting Southwest, just saying, thank you for doing what you're doing, thank you for getting the plane down
safe. I think that's a great
example. All of it, that's a perfect example of where right in the middle of a crisis, I mean, they would put up a statement on Facebook and these thousands of people would come in and say, thank you and thanks for helping out and taking control of the situation.
Right. And I think that leads me to the seventh A is that advertise in your brand. Have faith in your brand. Show that, signal that, and do not play hide and seek. And a lot of times when firms have crisis, they stop advertising because they don't want the brand name to be in the public. And definitely, by all means, do give promotions and make sure that they're compensated and so on. But maintain a steady level of faith in your brand and show that faith.
It's back to if you stand by yourself, I'll stand by you.
Exactly.
And again, you bring up that same process kind of mentality of, if you keep kind of a steady flow, they'll stay with you along that you know, road trip, if you will.
Absolutely.
They'll stay with you if you kind of keep steady.
So it strikes me there's actually an eighth A here that ought to be part of each and every step of the seven, and that is authenticity.
Absolutely.
Every one of those adds up to authenticity.
Right. All the seven A's, if you do it correctly, your brand becomes very authentic and most likable, desirable. People will stick with your brand. And they will almost internalize themselves saying, hey.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, I want to support this brand. It could happen to me. That's the kind of empathy that you want, reverse empathy you want.
Right.
Robert and I talk about that if you're doing the right steps, no matter what, social, advertising, if you're doing everything that we're talking about here, it gets you right here.
Right, the heart, yeah.
It gets you right there in the chest and the heart, and it becomes an emotional connection, not a product service connection. That's ultimately where you're trying to get.
Absolutely.
So you, as the leader of your business or organization, need to be asking, do I have the seven A's in place? And how do I do that? We're going to put some resources online that you can read the doctor's papers, and we want to thank you for hosting
us
here
again.
At Texas
A&M
today. And the May School of Business, what a fantastic place.
Yes.
Thank you.
Really enjoyed it.
Thanks again.
Thank you, Brad, and thank you, Robert.
Have a good one, guys.